Hey everyone, this is Todd Hazelton with mobileburn.com, and today we're checking out the HTC Incredible, it's the HTC DROID Incredible rather, a new phone on Verizon Wireless, Android 2.1, $199. It'll be available on April 29th in stores, but you can begin ordering it today, Monday the 19th. Let's check out the box real quick and then I'll do an unboxing for you. See, they just put the phone on both sides and what the box contains on the side here. Get the phone, lithium ion battery, USB charger, product safety and warranty brochure, and quick start guide. Let's open it up. All right, here's the device itself. You can see that it sort of looks like a topographical map, almost the way these edges fall on the side. Talked to HTC about it, and they said they built it around the look of a sports car. Definitely really cool, and I really like this little red metallic tint around the camera there. Very nice dual LED flash. That's an 8 megapixel camera. Nothing on the bottom. Micro USB charging here. So the volume control is kind of hard to see there. Power button up top, 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. Nothing on the other side. You'll notice there's no camera button, and that's because this button right here pushes in and lets you take pictures with that. Unfortunately, it doesn't launch the camera itself, the app, so you still have to launch that yourself. And that's what I would kind of would have preferred a dedicated button for. Up front here, we have the touch-sensitive buttons. They have a haptic feedback when you touch them when the phone is on. It's home, menu, return, and search, standard on Android phones. Inside the box here, you have tips, hints, and shortcuts. Standard with most phones these days. We have the charger, USB 2.0, and the micro USB charger. Works like this if you haven't seen it before. Very convenient. Lets you, plug it into your computer, transfer music, files, whatnot, or use the charger. Perfect. Now, I booted the phone up here to get it all set up ahead of time. What I wanted to show you inside the box was the battery, and get this open. Here we go. Pretty sweet undercover here. It's all red, kind of like a Ferrari colored, and that's a red battery there. Micro SD card goes in the side, supports up to 32 gigabytes. Now the phone itself has 8 gigs of storage on it already. Also under the hood, you have the 1 gigahertz Snapdragon processor. But I really like this feature. I don't, how often is anybody going to see the underside of a phone? But very nice looking. It really feels like a premium device, and it looks like one too. Battery cover goes on a little bit easier than taking it off. Here's the device itself. So let's get started into looking at HTC Sense, Android 2.1. and what Verizon has added to it. All right, here we are at the home screen. This is default. There are 7 home screens with HTC Sense. You can swipe across them like this, or you can use a little optical thing right here. And I'm just swiping my finger across it there. Switch between them all. HTC has its own widgets on them. Here you can see I just had a notification come in of a text message. Pops up right up top with the notification down. So back to what I was saying, HTC widgets are spread out across the device. You can, of course, take one, hold it, drag, drop, and add your own. You might notice already just the speed of this device. It feels really nice already. You can see a list of the widgets available. So if we wanted to add, say, footprints, click it, put it there. You can select different ones. There's a smaller version, but we'll use the big one. And voila. Show people where you visited. And that's the benefit of HTC Sense here, is that they let you customize the phone with these other, small widgets and stuff that they've created that aren't available for, standard Android 2.1 devices or others. HTC Sense is HTC's sort of, Moto Blur experience, but I think it goes a little more in-depth, actually a lot more in-depth than Moto Blur does. Here's an example. I'll show you this, the main menu here. I've installed a couple apps already, but it does come with a few of their own. You can see clock, desk clock, peep HTC's Twitter client. Well, I'll show you that really quick. So, nice Twitter list. Very good client. Enjoy using that. HTC has, they're also, let's see, I'll show you weather. You can find it here. Right under my thumb. A great weather application here. So, you can switch between cities in both New York right now. But you can add other cities. We'll go back to the home screen. And I want to show you this also. You can tell, you can see the live wallpaper in the background. That's Android 2.1. There are others. But what I want to show you is called Scenes. This is HTC's custom setup for their Sense. So you have Verizon, which is the current social, work, play, travel, and clean slate. Travel's a pretty neat one. I'll show you that. You can save your current theme whenever you need it. Done. So here's travel. So say you just landed in London and you need, here's New York time, Eastern time, and you need, a focus on travel. So here you go through my email. I have footprints because I can take pictures of where I've gone, share them with people. We'll go back. Here you have my music, Twitter, what's happening, update everybody, my calendar, if I had meetings, an empty slate there. And then, of course, common use things here for travel. Maps, good one. That was a quick look at the scenes there. Again, being Android 2.0 or newer, this is 2.1, has a navigation feature here. So this is HTC customized. It has footprints, navigate, voice search, view map, search, make a call. So, of course, navigate. Google Maps here, Google Navigation, it's free. Turn-by-turn, voice-guided directions. See, what else can I show you? I talked to Verizon Wireless today. They'll be launching this with Skype compatibility. They just launched that recently, so you can make free voice calls over their circuit switch network. So that's a great feature that will be supported on this. I don't see Rhapsody. That would have been a nice feature to add over-the-air downloads for music. I installed Slacker to replace that. So you can see, FM radio also has an FM radio. That's pretty sweet. Of course, you'll need to use your own headphones with that. Headphones didn't come with this. Voicemail's integrated with messages. Really nice looking. I didn't set it up yet, but I saw it on a demo unit today. So they'll come in visual voicemail there. This is a neat way to switch everything. You can either hit the home screen, the home button here twice, jump to my emails. To Twitter, to whatever part of that home screen you need. Let's check out the camera. And here you can see it's an 8-megapixel camera. And to take a picture, like I said earlier, just kind of hover your finger here for the autofocus where you can touch the screen and grab a shot. Pretty neat. And then as part of Android also, you can quickly share it with anything, Facebook, Flickr, Gmail, Peep, Picasa. Pretty neat. One thing I forgot to mention too is you can see this brilliant screen. It's an AMOLED display. Very bright, very colorful. It's beautiful to look at, and I don't know if the camera can show you that, as well as seeing it in person, so I recommend checking it out before you make a purchase. Brings me up to email. This does support Exchange, so you can pull in your Exchange contacts. And during setup, when you first turn on the phone, you can enter in all your user information for Facebook, Twitter, Gmail, Exchange, etc. All right, let's take a quick look at the web browser here. Here I've started loading Mobile Burn, our home page already. Very iPhone-like experience. Of course, there's pinch to zoom. Zoom in on a spot, pull back out. Hit menu. You can view your open windows. Here I just have one. Bookmarks. All represented here in a nice thumbnail fashion. These are all preloaded, So I didn't even add those yet. So pretty neat. Let's see. Your favorites, most visited. And today, the history for today. Shoot back to the home screen here. I'll show you the music player. These are some preloaded tracks on our test unit. Speakers get loud there. Now you can switch tracks by dragging it like that. Here's a list of the artists. Of course, you can view them like that as well. Then sort by album, playlist, all songs, genres, composers, or music that you have purchased. Back to the home screen. You can see the music still playing here in the background. Might be a little hard to hear, but it's still going there. Take a look at stocks. So we don't have any stocks. Here you can see I'm having a little trouble typing over the camera here, but in general the keyboard's very good. As a matter of fact, landscape one, it's not supported in this app. I'll show it to you in just a second. Okay, so here we have a stock. We just added Intel down today. Kind of neat. Go to the home screen. So. Stop the music now. Go back to the home screen here. Let's check out the messaging so I can show you the keyboard. What are my little messages? So, there we go. We have the landscape. See the auto correct is on. Even picked up my name there. So very easy to type on. I like it a lot so far. I have the haptic feedback turned on. I'll probably turn that off as I'm not the biggest fan of that, but it's there if you want it. You can also search by voice here. And you can see, or I'm sorry, type by voice. And that just popped up, search by voice here. So pretty neat. That's a quick look here at the HTC Incredible. $199, Verizon Wireless. Again, it'll be available on the 29th of this month, April 29th. Pre-orders begin today, the 19th. And this is Todd Hazelton with Mobile Burn taking a quick look at the DROID Incredible from HTC.